all this, my dear friend, there is hope for you. Whatever you are going through, whether sickness, whether pain, whether trouble, whether depression, whether financial crisis, whether marital problems, there is healing for you in Christ Jesus.
Good evening, viewers. I want to wish you a happy new year, and I believe that this new year, 2003, will be a wonderful, a beautiful, and excellent year for you. It shall be a year of great things, a year of signs, a year of wonders, a year of miracles. I believe that this year is loaded with bountiful blessings for you, overwhelming joy, exceeding greatness. God will take you to new heights in the mighty name of Jesus. In the light of this, we have a guest in the house today, and that's in the person of Pastor Alakija. You'll be meeting him after a very short break. And then before we meet him, I will tell you one or two things about the new year. But I believe that you had a wonderful holiday, and you're going to have a great time in this particular episode. God bless you. Hold on for a short break. You're welcome back. Now, I want us to read a few scriptures. First of all, let's first introduce our guest, and then I will read some scriptures before our guest continue from where I was stopped. Pastor, you're welcome to healing the hurting, fulfilling God's purpose, glorifying God. We are so happy to have you. Happy New Year to you and to your family.
Thank you very much.
I would like our viewers to meet you before we continue, sir.
I am Pastor Olusei Alakija. Presently, I am the assistant chaplain of the Redeemers University Redemption Camp presently, but we are moving to Ede for sure.
Amen. 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 You're welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Viewers, there are a few things I would like to tell you about this new year. I'm sure, hopefully, I believe that you have listened and watched the program by our Father and the Lord, my daddy, Pastor Iyadeboye, and some of the prophecies given by him at the watch night, at the crossover night service. A lot of things were said. Some of these things will be put on the screen for you to see some of the prophecies given for individuals, for international, and for Nigeria. You can watch them on the screen just towards, as the program goes on, they will show you, and then you can see what some of the prophets given. Now, I want us to look at some scriptures to prepare our mind for the new year. Now, if you look with me into the book of Isaiah, chapter 43. Isaiah chapter 43 from verse 18, and verses 18 and 19. Now, the Bible says, it says to us, it says, "Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. You shall not know, shall you not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." I have a word for you viewers today, that by the grace of God, as the Lord lives, by his mercies, in this year 2013, God will make a way for you. He will do a new thing in your life. Whatever happened to you in 2012, put it behind you. However, you can gain by learning the lesson from the past mistakes of last year, and then look forward to a new year, correcting the past and doing new things in a new way. And I'm sure the Lord also will back you up and will bring your desires to pass in this new year. This year has come with a lot of promises, a lot of blessings loaded in it for you and I. And I don't want you, I would not like any of us to miss the great blessings that this year has come with for us. This year is a year of signs and wonders and miracles. It's a year that's so powerful. It's a very strategic year. It's a very important year in the entire world, and also particularly in your life and in my life. So we cannot afford to waste any minute and to miss any blessing. And I know that God is going to give us tremendous blessings in this new year, in the name of Jesus. Secondly, so put the past behind you and look forward to the new things. Last year is gone. You only have this new year to live and to enjoy. And Thirdly, the Lord says, he says, what he wants to do springs forth now. He says, now it springs forth. He says, shall you not know it? So it begins now. It will manifest. All the promises of God for you and the prophecies given shall come to pass. You shall see it manifested before your very eyes by the grace of God in the name of Jesus. And how will this be? The scripture says, it says, he will make a way in the wilderness. The one who is able to do all things, it will make a way for you in the wilderness. How God is going to make you to have babies this year, I don't know, but he says he will make a way in the wilderness. How you get a job, I may not know it, but he says he will make a way for you in the wilderness. How you will have a new anointing, how God will take you to that nation you are planning to go to, and you get a visa and be able to have ticket to go, I don't know, but God says he will make a way in the wilderness. Who he will use, I don't know. But I have a word, because I know that God will send help to you. That help will come to you from Baal Shalisha, from the four winds of the heavens and the earth. He will send help to you. He may use people you know. He may use people you don't know. He may use believers. He may use unbelievers. He may even use animals. He may use the wind. He may use the soil. He may use the ground. He may use the waters. He may use the rivers. Whatever he decides, he may use angels to bring help to you. But all I know is that help comes from the Lord that made the heavens and the earth. He will send help to you. And he will make a way in the wilderness. Whether we use caterpillar or bulldozer or whatever means he wants to do it, it doesn't really matter to you. What matters is that God says he will make a way in the wilderness. And also, he says he will create rivers in the desert. So all your dryness this year shall be over, because the Lord will make rivers for you to flow in the desert, in the mighty name of Jesus. Also, I want you to read with me from Psalm 61. I want you to look 61 verse 2. It says, from the ends of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than high. This is the prayer that you and I need to pray this year, that God will take us to the rock that is higher than high. This is a year of new heights. A year that God will do something new, something wonderful in our lives. And also, Isaiah 55 verse 9 says, say, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Now, what God has said to do for you and I this year are things that your mind can't even comprehend at all. They are higher than you can comprehend. They are too big for you to imagine. They are wonderful things. They are excellent things. They are beautiful things. And I know the Lord will help you to get there in the name of higher heights. Is your portion, and it's going to be your testimony. So, Pastor Lakija, I want us to take together also to read together from the book of Joel chapter 2 from verse 18 downwards. Joel chapter 2 from verse 18. And then we'll be speaking to be sharing. I want us to look together on this issue of higher heights and the beautiful things the Lord is said to do for us and for our viewers in this new year. Now it says, then the Lord will be jealous for his land and pity his people. Yet the Lord will answer and say to his people, behold, I will send you corn and wine and oil, and you shall be satisfied therewith. And I will no more make you a reproach among the heathen, but I will remove far from you the northern army, and will drive him into a barren and a desolate, and with his face towards the east sea, and his hinder part towards the uttermost sea. His stink shall come up, and his ill servant shall come up. But because he had done great things, fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do great things. Be not afraid, ye beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness do spring. For the tree beareth fruit, the fig tree and the vine do yield their strength. Be glad, ye children of Zion. Rejoice in the Lord your God, for he hath given you the former rain moderately, and he will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. And the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fat shall overflow with wine and oil. I will restore to you the years that the locust had eaten, and the cankerworm, and the caterpillar, and the palmerworm, my great army which I sent among you. You shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, that hath dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed. You shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, that I am the Lord your God, and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed. Now you can read further down, but stopping there, I believe these are the things that the Lord will do for somebody that is hearing the sound of my voice, including myself, and that you shall be your testimony. You can hold on to this word and believe God for it and claim it for yourself, and the Lord will gladden your heart and fulfill His purpose in Jesus' name. And Pastor, higher heights. I believe that is what where God is taking me to.
And of course, me.
I thought I'm the only one going.
And
the viewers too. Now, sir, over to you.
Well, I want to thank God. The plan of God, as the scriptures has already established, and also confirmed with the prophecies that have come forth from our Father in the Lord, has it clearly that this year will be a better and a higher year in terms of results and productivity than the past year. And so I want us to start looking at it from the point view of the mind of God concerning us. The book of Proverbs chapter 4 verse 18 says, "The path of the just man is as a shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day." The perfect day in question here is the second coming of the Lord. So the plan of God is that the saints of God will be better as His coming approaches. So it is prophetic. It's a divine agenda of God that the past years will no way be better than the years that are ahead of us.
Hallelujah.
So it is clear that this is one of the years that God has made up His mind in right from the beginning that we are going to be better. But looking at our scriptures, it says that the path of the just man is as the shining light. So for the children of God, for the believers, it is a settled matter.
Hallelujah.
That this year is going to be better than 2012.
Hallelujah.
So because of righteousness,
amen.
The path of the just is as a shining light. So starting with that foundation, we know that if we will walk in righteousness, we will not need to struggle this year.
Amen.
And that also reminds us of a particular story in scriptures, the story of the man called Isaac. The times that Isaac lived looked like our time. Things are, economics are failing, you know, money is scarce, resources, and so we can say that there is a global famine. And so Isaac lived in a time such as what we have now. And so if we look at the book of Genesis chapter 26, verse 2, the Bible said that, "And the Lord appeared unto Isaac and said to him, do not go down to Egypt." However, when we move on to verse 12 and 14, we'll see in that same Bible passage, the Bible tells us that, "And the man Isaac waxed strong, he increased in all manner of things, and he kept prospering until the point where even a nation of the Philistine began to envy him." So that is higher height. And that's what God has in store for us here.
Amen.
But there is a link. There is a connection. It says that before Isaac could arrive at that point,
yeah,
at that end result of higher height,
yeah,
where nations, friends, colleagues, neighbors, contemporaries were envious of his testimony,
yeah,
the key to it is that Isaac had first, do not go down. And do not go down in this sense means that, one, avoid every form of unrighteousness. So for us this year, the key to attain the higher heights that God has for us as believers, as children of God, is we must avoid every form of unrighteousness.
Yeah.
That's what Egypt symbolizes in that context.
Yeah.
And then secondly,
righteousness exalts
a nation. Sin is
a reproach to a people.
Anybody. Now, secondly, if we must also have higher heights in all of our endeavors this year, we must not do it according to the world system. Because Egypt, in context as we look at it, happened to be the standard, the benchmark. So God said, no, you don't have to do it the way people are doing it.
Don't go to Egypt.
Don't
use the approach.
Don't use the approach.
Don't follow their ways.
No, don't follow the approach. Don't follow the system of the world. It's going to be, if you must have higher heights, you must have higher strategy. And the Bible says that all gifts and blessings, all good gifts, They come from above, from the Father of light. Mm. You know, James chapter 1, verse 17. From God. So it means if we are going to have higher heights, we must operate with strategies that are from
above.
From above, from God.
Looking up.
Yes, divine strategies.
Amen.
So we must not condescend to the strategies of the world.
Hallelujah.
And it also means that no compromise.
Amen.
No compromise. You either be hot or you are cold.
Amen.
You either for God or you are not there.
Hallelujah.
So that in itself tells us how we are going to make it this year to higher heights. Of course, in that same scriptures, from that verse 2, God also was speaking to Isaac.
Yeah.
And the Bible said, the Lord appeared to Isaac.
Mm-hmm.
So it also means that this year, if we are going to have higher achievements, higher results, we must seek God's revelation. We must demand that we hear him. We must demand that we see him. We must demand divine guidance. We must seek that he should guide us.
Mm.
And when he guides us, he will be leading us to profit.
Praise God.
So this I believe are some of the things that
we must
spend plenty of time, quality time with him, so that he can guide us in the affairs of life. So that we won't just be running from pillar to post.
Mm.
We will be guided.
Doing trial and error.
No trial and error this year. It will be precisely as he says. Do this, do that, and then the testimonies will be abounding. Notwithstanding what others are passing through.
Yeah.
So I believe that these are some of the things. And also, I want to also believe that if we are going to have higher heights this year, the Bible tells us that in Romans chapter 10, verse 10, it says, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word. Jesus Christ was speaking to his disciples in the book of Matthew chapter 17, verse 21. He said, this kind goeth not,
mm-hmm.
but by prayer and fasting.
Mm.
So there are a lot of things mixed together there. Now, we need faith if we want to operate at a higher level this year.
Mm.
You know, if we look at faith, you see in scripture, Jesus was telling his disciples, say, you little faith.
Yeah.
There was a time he said, no faith at all.
Mm.
And there was a time he said, great faith.
Mm.
And there was a time he said, also exceeding great faith.
Mm.
So if we want higher manifestations,
mm.
then we must move on to a higher level of faith.
Mm. Increase in faith.
Our faith must be increased
mm.
in God. Our trust and dependence in God must be there so that we will not struggle with him. We will allow him. You know, faith is living what God can do into God's hand to do.
Hallelujah.
And doing what man ought to do.
Mm-hmm.
So that is faith. So which means that, and for faith to come, faith is only being propelled by the word of God. Without the word of God, our faith cannot
grow. Romans chapter 10.
10 verse 10. So we must strive
faith
also to
comes
know
by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
So we must increase in our word consumption. We must increase in our interaction with the word of God, with which our word can become a higher one this year. So we need to also operate at a higher level of God's word.
Spending more time to read,
yes.
to speak,
yes.
and then to meditate.
To declare it.
Joshua chapter 1 verse 8.
Exactly. Mm. So and then of course, we mentioned the issue of faith. And then also the issue of prayer.
Mm.
Like I said, Matthew chapter 17 verse 21, Jesus said, this kind goeth not but by prayer and fasting.
Yeah, first, yeah.
If we want higher heights this year, we must also go to the higher level in prayer.
Hallelujah.
We must go higher in prayer.
Mm.
And then maybe let me try to also bring it home with this, that there is also a place of service in attaining higher heights.
Mm.
In the book of Matthew, where the story, the parable that the Lord told his disciples of a husband man who wanted to travel, and as a result, had gifts apportioned to his servants.
Yeah.
Told us of one who got 5, 2, and 1.
Yeah.
The Bible tells us in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verse 23, he says, he that is faithful in little, much will be committed into his hands.
Yeah.
So if we want higher level of operation this year, we must strive to serve God and serve him faithfully in the little.
Be committed into doing something that is given to you to do.
Do that very well. You are just a cleaner in the office. You are aspiring for better things, better promotion. It means clean it diligently. Clean it faithfully. Whether somebody is watching, whether nobody is watching, do that which you are called to do with all sense of duty.
Amen.
And God will also lift you.
Amen.
And because we are privileged to be in a church like this, I want to also say that one secret that we also lift us to higher ground is humility. Mm. Humility. That is, it is the nature of God. And in the book of James chapter 4 verse 10, the Bible says, humble yourself under the mighty hands of God, and in due season he will lift. And where we want to go is higher heights. Amen. So, and the Bible says, underneath him are the everlasting. Yes, so, which is able to carry us. No matter what a man does for his colleagues, he can't carry him higher than his position. So, amen, if you want a position that is higher this year, you want higher elevation, higher lifting, then humble yourself. And then you see God who is able to lift a man. I mean, lifting us up to very higher heights.
Amen. Amen. And Pastor, because we have to round up now because of our time, I want you to look at somebody looking at the camera,
okay,
and speak to that person,
okay,
that is been crying, lift me up, oh God, and speak hope,
right,
and speak life,
right.
Because viewer, last time it had been a year that you were right in the mud, and you are just down, going to the pit, you found yourself, every effort kept going down. But this year, in the name that's above every other name, the Lord will lift you.
Amen.
And as the man of God speaks, believe God.
Amen.
Because every word spoken will be prophetic in your life.
Amen.
You shall be lifted.
Amen.
You shall be lifted.
Amen.
You shall be lifted from sorrow, from depression, from failure,
amen,
from poverty, from
amen,
depression, from
amen,
dejection, from sadness, from whatever.
Amen.
From bondage.
Amen.
You shall be lifted.
Amen.
You are going up this year. This is your year of higher heights.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
So there, viewers, you are there, that man that is believing God for a higher lifting in his career. The Bible says, thou will arise and have mercy on Zion. For the time to favor has come, the set time. I speak to you by the Spirit of the Lord. Your set time is now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. You will have testimonies to this.
Amen.
And God will take the glory. That young lady,
amen,
you are old enough to be married. Your higher height is to, for that change of name from Miss to Mrs. I speak to you by the Spirit of the Lord. There will be divine connection for you,
amen,
and you shall be lifted.
Amen.
That man in debt, you are owing so much and you don't know how. You are trying your best and things seems not to be working. I speak to you by the Spirit of the Lord. Ways will open for you. Even where you least expect ways, the doors shall be open unto you.
Amen.
And I speak to you, that one who is suffering frustration, you are lonely, you are abandoned. It seems as if help is not coming from everywhere. That you know, those you have helped in time past are now running away from you. The God of heaven, the helper of the helpless, is right there with you. And is lifting you up with his everlasting arms.
Amen.
And you are rising into limelight.
Amen.
All those who have forsaken you, they are locating you this year.
Amen.
Your helpers will come beckoning.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are lifted.
Amen.
You are lifted.
Amen.
So it is in Jesus' name.
Amen. And the barrier shall be lifted.
Amen.
It shall go on higher ground.
Amen. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
The one who took Hannah,
yes,
from the low level of barrenness,
yes,
and made her to go higher,
yes,
and start having more children.
Yes.
As you became mother of children,
yes,
that same God will lift you.
Amen.
You are going to a higher ground.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you are in debt, it will help you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are coming out of debt.
Amen.
You are going to a higher ground.
Amen.
And if you are spiritually down in sin, you are lifted up to the level of righteousness.
Amen.
And that's why we'll be rounding up this session with an altar call. You don't have to continue the way you lived last year. It's time to live a new life. The scripture says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, if any man be in Christ, is a new creature. God wants to make you to become somebody new. Everything will change. You are going to a higher ground. You are going to a higher height.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. You don't want to have to be living among the dead. The dead are those who are living in sin. But be among the living who are serving a living God. And they worship God in spirit and in truth. Now, you can come out of sin by you surrendering your life to Christ, repenting of your sins. Bible says, though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. The Lord can cleanse you from your sin. They will be as red as crimson. They shall be as white as wool. The Lord will cleanse away your sins. He's faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all our righteousness. That's 1 John chapter 1. He will give you a new beginning.
Amen.
He will put the past behind you. Now, if you are there, you have been born again, but you keep backsliding, today you can. The Lord can give you a turnaround again and bring you back to Himself and take you from backsliding state to a higher height. And if you are there, you have been born again, sanctified, but you are not filled with the Holy Spirit. It's your year to be not only filled with the Holy Ghost, but to be soaked and saturated with the power of the Holy Spirit. You will speak in tongues and move in the level of the supernatural as we found it in Acts chapter 2 from verses 1 to 4. God will give you a new experience of the Holy Spirit. And if you are speaking in tongues, you begin to pray in a new dimension of anointing, interceding for the nations, and beginning to do great things for God. It is your year of higher heights in the name of Jesus. Our daddy said, this year will be better than last year. And I believe that word is for you and it's for me. I would like us to pray now, even as Pastor Alakija prays with us today in the name of Jesus. It is your year of a higher height.
Amen.
You are going higher.
Amen.
So, Pastor, I want us to pray.
Let us pray. Father, we want to thank you for our viewers all over the world. We want to bless you especially for your plan and your intention to take every one of us to higher heights this year. We want to bless your name for it. Take all the glory in Jesus' name. And so, Lord, for those who are hurting, those who are depressed, those who are frustrated, who have heard your word this evening and have made up their mind to put their trust in God and try again in career, in business, in marriage, in whatever areas, Lord, I ask, because your word is powerful, and it will not return unto you void until it has accomplished the purpose for which it is sent. You said, come unto me, O ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Father, we ask that as your people have heard your word, please prove and confirm yourself unto them in Jesus' name. Lord, everyone that is down, please lift them up in Jesus' name. You have promised us higher heights. Lord, together we believe you, and we ask that for us and all our viewers, Lord, you will lift us onto higher levels of operations in Jesus' name. We will no longer, O Lord God, fish in shallow waters this year in Jesus' name. And strategically and prophetically, you have spoken that this year will be better than the past. So let it be unto us in Jesus' name. For those who have just given their lives unto you, we ask that your mighty hand will keep them unto the very end in Jesus' name. You will sustain them and you will uphold them. We pray that you continually bless our nation and bless your church and bless this program and bless this station. Thank you, Almighty.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen. Viewers, my friend that wants to give his life to Christ and you want to live a holy life, you want to live a righteousness and God to exalt you, I would like you to bow your heads now and say this prayer after me. Say, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I repent of my sins. I don't want to remain down. I want to go up with you in righteousness. Please have mercy upon me. Forgive my sins. Wash me in the blood of Jesus. Write my names in the Lamb's book of life. I believe Jesus died for me. He shed his blood for me. Remember my sins no more. I receive Jesus into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior. Thank you, Lord Jesus, live in me forever. And when the trumpet shall sound, let me be raptured with the saints of God. I love you. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for forgiving my sins. Glory be to your holy name. Keep me to the very end. And use me to save others too. And save my entire household. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen. Father, thank you for these ones who have surrendered their lives to Christ today and those who rededicated their lives to Christ. I pray, Lord, you forgive them.
Amen.
Wash them in the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Take them to a higher height.
Amen.
Let there be a new beginning in their lives. Let them reign with you in righteousness or to eternity.
Amen.
And let them have the joy of salvation and the peace with God.
Amen.
And let the blood of Jesus avail for them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let all be well with them.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
And that fellow that is watching, that is sick, lift him from sickness and disease and oppression and wickedness and bondage. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be lifted from yoke.
Amen.
Be lifted from bondage.
Amen.
Be lifted from captivity.
Amen.
Be raised up from sick.
Amen.
Sicknesses and diseases.
Amen.
You are healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We rebuke that infirmity. You are made whole.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
For it is done.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray. That pain, Amen. You feel it no more.
Amen.
That trouble, you feel it no more.
Amen.
It's a new beginning for you.
Amen.
You are lifted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Congratulations, our viewers. This year shall be a year of lifting for you.
Amen.
We're glad you watched us today. You joined us in this program. And we're glad that you will join. We believe you will join us throughout this year. Don't miss the next episode. It's going to be very glorious and very wonderful. And make sure you invite others to join you to watch this program. Thank you so much for being part of this program. We're very grateful to you for your viewing today. And the Lord bless you. See you the same time next week on Healing the Hurting, Fulfilling God's Purpose, Glorifying God. Pastor Alakija, thank you so much, sir, for being with us today. You have been a blessing to us. And pray God will take you to a higher height also.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is your year. Don't forget it. And remember the scriptures we read at the beginning. They are scriptures for you. They shall be fulfilled in your life.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
And amen.